Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the latest in the Just Cause line, Just Cause 3. Square Enix launched this game 2 days ago, and I've been messing about with it since then. I find this game really, really hard to put down. It's just fantastic. The gameplay is brilliant, the jokes are really funny, and they combine these two together to create a game that's always interesting. The word I would describe this game with is fun. You know, I can jump off like this, open a wingsuit, fly around, and then go shoot people. Like, there was more to want. I like the game and the way it works. It's beautiful as well. I mean, if you just stop and look around and see the map, the island of Medici is where it's set. It's just stunning. This is the console version, by the way. So this is what it looks like on console. The PC one is beautiful as well. They've done a fantastic job. I mean, there is a reason why this game has won so many awards. I've always liked it, and especially this one, because it allows you to do, you know, anything you want. There is so many customizations available with nearly every part of the game. You know, and there is. It gives you a reason to carry on playing and doing missions and that sort of stuff. If I show you the map, you can just get a sense of how big the game actually is. I mean, so this is the entirety of the map. That's, I don't know what that is yet. So the point of the game, or from what I've seen so far, is you have to try and, you're trying to take down the a new dictator, just like you did in the old one. So you can capture these little areas by taking out these small bases and taking these towns for the rebels, and it colours it in blue. So this is the blue and red border, as that's as far as I pushed forward yet. We've also got a tiny little place down here. So you take these out, and then you'll get this island, and then if you take out this one, you get that island. And once you got to the end, you'll be able to take out the dictator regime. This is a little place we took earlier. So if I show you the gear mods, this is what I mean about how customizable this game is. So these are just the destruction ones. So you can do glass grenades that explode when they hit things, and grenades that home on targets, and ones that will explode quicker when they detect enemies, and more grenades. You can just have all the grenades if you want to. I mean, you can make sure that there are these. You can have booster explosives, which many of you have already seen. You can set them off, and they're a bit like little rockets. They'll shoot out and make things go off into the distance before they explode. And there are also safety ones as well, and there's just so much stuff. They've kept a lot of things from the old game. So the idea that you can call in a friend and bring down a drop. You can select your two-handed weapon, your assault rifles and shotguns, etc. Then you can bring down your pistols, and then you can then pick out a special, which I haven't unlocked any yet, and then you can get your vehicles, so be it a military car or a helicopter or whatever, it all gets dropped down. Something I like, actually, in this menu is the fact that there are so many things unlocked already. If I just show you this, I mean, you have a wide selection of things you can pick, each one doing things. So this is a burst fire, whereas this is just a full auto, and this one's a single shot. Or you can go for the light machine gun or the shotguns or whatever. I mean, you can just see how many vehicles there are as well. I mean, these are all the sports ones, and, you know, tanks, helicopters, all these. With my addition, I got the weaponized versions of some of the boats, which is, I have yet to test them out, and I'm looking for a time when I can actually go and blow things up using the boats and that sort of stuff. Not that's to say there's not much to blow up. There is a huge amount to this game. I mean, when they were advertising it, they just had a ball of fire behind them, and that's pretty much what I spend all my time doing. You know, in the first mission, I had an RPG trying to blow things up. I didn't, you know, I haven't felt that. I haven't blown many things up yet. And it's not got boring either. The game hasn't got boring. So if I show you this, so I'm going to place a waypoint here, and we're going to try and take out this little place. So I'm probably not in the best vehicle. In fact, I will call in a supply drop and then we'll go shoot it with that. So if you can see, or you could see in the right hand side of my screen, it came up when it told me when I was in view of the authorities. That's something that is so useful, because half the time you're not quite sure if you've been spotted or whatever. And for them to show you, you know, what's going on and you know what, if you're conceding or not, or if it's safe to reload and stuff, it's just a really, really useful thing. I feel like they've added really useful things that maybe you didn't realize before. Okay, so we're going to go for, okay, if we do a military car, and I will pick that one, and I don't need anything else, so I'm gonna do that. And that costs a beacon, so these beacons you actually find around the map and in missions and stuff, and these are how you call in your supply drop. So I'm gonna throw onto the ground, and if I look above, there it is. And so this container will carry anything from cars to helicopters and planes, etc. Everything you need. Okay, here we go. Okay, so I'm just gonna drive up to the gate. So if you're looking at how to take these things out, in the left hand corner there are all the circles. They are and you can see actually seven down, there is one that looks like a radar dish, and I think there's three on this from what I can see. So the more you blow up, the more that it will fill up, and then once it's done that, it will disappear and you'll be one step closer to taking the base. All right, if we can just, let's just make ourselves known. Oh my god. You see what I mean about explosions? There's just so many. Oh, that could be bad. Okay. Let's take out some of this. Okay, so I'm just going to select the C4. You have unlimited C4. I mean, that doesn't... What more could you want from a game, really, than just unlimited explosions? Okay, so you see in the left-hand side, it's filled up just that little bit as well. Let's take him out. I'm going to have to run away from here. Right, let's get some high ground. Ah! The movement's interesting. Oh, tank. In this game, sometimes I feel like I get stuck a little bit. I don't know why, so let's just blow him up. Okay, so above me is a helicopter. Yeah, take him down. Where else? Okay, so I'm going to take out this stuff. You as well. This is brilliant. So the way you unlock stuff is you find it as well. So, if you find stuff in the game, it will then appear in your unlocks. Oh damn, I missed. And it means that I don't have to try and rampage through the game trying to complete everything quickly just so that I can finish off. I think, okay, so these are the main things I'm supposed to be taking out. I think, okay, someone has an RPG or a helicopter. In fact, okay, we're gonna try and take that helicopter. So they've changed how you get the helicopters, because if you remember before, you had to sort of use that, you had to press the buttons on time. And okay, I need my tank back. Okay, let's get back into there. It was that quick time mini game. I think I never really enjoyed that. I thought it was, sometimes it worked for me, sometimes it didn't. They made little improvements and they've just decided to scrap that now and just allow you to get into it. And it's the same from when you're grappling and you try and get it on something, instead of pressing X and having to jump off and then sort of land yourself, they've made it so that it just does it automatically now as well. There is a bit of lag to this game. I have noticed that. I don't know if it's just because there are just so many things exploding, but I feel like the frame rate does drop, considering some places. I think they will probably fix this. There's been, you know, lots of notes saying that they're on this and they're gonna change it in some patches. I don't know exactly how they're gonna do it unless they, I mean, this is a hardware issue rather than less of an optimization issue. There's been a couple of visual glitches as well. Oh dear. I don't know how I'm gonna. Can I hack the SAM turrets? Okay, I reckon I can hack the SAM turrets. Okay. Can I hack it? Please let me hack it. Okay, right. So I can take control of like the SAM turrets and stuff. Oh. Damn. So the progress gets saved as well. So when we go back onto this, everything will be as it was. Which is nice, because it means you don't have to start again. I mean, there's so many frustrating things is once you've just, you know, once you've died or whatever, you can no longer, you see my SAM turret going off, but you can no longer carry on from where you left off. And I feel like they've sort of changed this. And a lot of this game is just little things that have bugged me in the past. Bugs me less now, so I'm just gonna flick up and I'm onto this. So this is, I got some beacons here. So we use these to call in that supply drop that allows me to have weapons and stuff. Like usual, we get little weapon drops. Okay, where is that? And take them out. They're quite weak, the helicopters and stuff in this game. I mean, I that's good, because I mean the amount of times I've been killed by them is just, I still get really angry at them in the end, but the fact that you can shoot them down pretty really quickly is something useful. So what am I supposed to take out now? Ah, okay, so these are the satellite dishes. Just like everything else, it has to be taken out for you to claim the thing. So, or claim the base. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna attach this to you and then put you up. Amazing. I don't know how you could not want to do that. There's just so much freedom in this game. So new things, like you can pull things towards other things, pull things down. Okay, let's go down here. And you know, more grappling things together as well. You can grapple up to three things together. I'm stuck on these mountains. Which just, it does feel like Just Cause 2.0 or Just Cause 2.0. There's a lot of changes that makes the game so much smoother as well. And so much more playable. Oh, where are you? Come here. Jeez. I mean, the fact that anyone can survive that is a bloody miracle, really, if you think about it. Okay. Let's go to this. Take things out using this. Okay, so there's weapons over there. I don't know if they can see me or not. It hasn't indicated that they can see me, so I think they haven't. Oh, this is something you have to take out as well. So these are like the power things. Okay, so I only have five things to take out. I have to take out that big satellite up there. Jeez. Okay, so I'm really, really close to dying. If there's any enemies, it will actually highlight them to me. Which is unbelievably useful. I mean, especially when I'm fighting with people, it means that I don't start taking out the wrong things and shooting down or shooting at friendlies, because you know, I spent a good 15 minutes trying to taking out the friendlies, and when I was taking out bases, I didn't realize that I was supposed to be doing an objective. I sometimes feel that the objectives aren't highlighted to me as well as they maybe could be. There's these, you know, as you've seen, there are these small little dots going around, and there's one over here that indicates where I'm supposed to be going, but sometimes they appear. I don't know why they don't. It might be just because they actually want me to try and work it out myself without having to tell me constantly. Or it might just be because it hasn't bothered to show up. But either way, it is frustrating when I'm trying to run around doing things. Okay, so I'm going to hack this Sam turret. Come on. I like the fact you can hack some of these stuff. Okay, I'm just... So, unlimited C4, brilliant. I mean, whoever thought of that is a genius. I mean, who doesn't want unlimited explosives? And then we're just going to take it out. Okay, so we've got to do the big radar up there. I think we have to take out some other power things. We probably have to take out these helicopters. I don't know if they are ours or not. I assume they're not. By the fact that... Oh, no, they are ours. Okay. Oh, yeah, okay, because they're blue. I wonder if he'll let me use them, because I really don't want to just try and walk around doing it. I haven't quite got used to the controls yet. I don't know why, but they don't feel as smooth as they could be. I mean, I keep trying to press X to, they don't feel like they're configured correctly. Like, I press X to try and shoot people, and I forget it's L1 and R1. X just opens your parachute, which kind of getting on my nerves. The amount of times I've actually just tried to blow things up and ended up just jumping out, like, oh, crap. Okay, let's take this bloody thing up. Come on, you bastard. Okay, how am I supposed to blow you up? Am I being shot at? Oh, I am. Okay. Never had a chance. Take you guys out, and you... Okay, this looks like something I have to take out. Okay, that's another transformer taken out. As well. Okay, let's go around. I want to know where the last transformer is. So they do really want you to try and explore and try to find out. I like the fact that he isn't hand you want to play. I mean, it does make it a bit more interesting. But equally, I have spent so many, 35 minutes on just one part trying to work out where the hell I have to blow up next. I don't know if it was because I ignored all the tutorials at the beginning. I mean, I'm sure if you didn't, they would tell you what you're supposed to do. I had no idea what the circles were supposed to be, or what the symbols meant as well. There is, you are supposed to take out these billboards, and I had no idea that I was supposed to do it, because the picture was like a rectangle with a little face in there. Okay, so all I've got left now, there's something over here, I think. Yep. So these are more of the hidden ones now. Okay, let's go down. Oh, having a helicopter really, really does make it easier. Here we go. Anything else? Where are you? Okay, so there's a sniper trying to snipe me out. Okay, I'm just going to blow this up. Enemy helicopter. Nice. Cool, okay, so I've only got one more transformer. Or one more electrical thing. I think it's an electrical thing. I'm not quite sure. Okay. Where the hell is that coming from? That's nasty though, whatever. Oh, it is actually coming down from there. Oh god, it's hard to aim. Okay. Maybe it's on this itself. Wouldn't surprise me. Okay, so I have actually partly blown it up. Excuse me. Come on. Okay, C7. Boom. Okay, last thing now. Is that it down there? I'm loving the dramatic music. It's really dramatic, but I can't find what the hell I'm supposed to blow up, so it seems to go on forever. Okay, let's go on afoot. Holy man. Okay, I'm gonna die pretty soon if I don't get out of here. Run, run! Where is the bastard? Oh, you're up there. No, I want you. Okay, so this is the three round burst gun. I'm not sure if I like it or not. It feels very spongy. like sometimes it will fire pretty quick after each other. Sometimes it has a long break. I don't know what, if it's just because of the lag. And like aiming in this is hard as well. I'm not massive fan of the way you aim. I can't find a way to actually focus the fire in to aim properly. Like most of the time, it's just sort of like from the hip, which is all right if I'm running around. But sometimes I want to try and focus where I'm going. Maybe I have to configure that, but I'm not sure. Okay, so let's go over to the old helicopter because I can't find a way of actually finding this unless I'm from the air. So I've only got one thing as well. I don't know where it is. Okay, let's go this way. It'd be nice if after a while it recognised that you had no idea where you're going. If you're getting close to something, it will indicate it to you. So it will just like it looks a bit like. It looks a bit like mobile phone signal, and the closer you get to it, it increases, and it has an audio trigger for that as well, so you know where you're going. That's really cool, although it did take a while for me to work out how the hell I use it. Okay, we're going to have to get out of it. My Sam's still working for me, which is lovely. There he is. Okay, everything is very broken. This game is not sure of explosions. Okay, yeah, foot's gonna have to. It's gonna have to be. It must still be on this, or maybe it's down here and I've just missed it. Maybe it's up here. If you pile into the little satellite dishes, it just breaks. Oh, see, that's all. Okay, here's some weapons. I'm gonna pick up something and see what they got. This is really bugging me. I can't find it though. Right, so after 45 minutes, I have found it. I must have missed it when I came down, so I spent all my time up there trying to find it. And here it is, right. I'm just going to put this on it. I'm going to put all three on it just to make it even better as well. This thing's been really annoying. Lights out. There we go. It's mine. Oh, see, it looks like I got a new sniper. So there we go. It'd be useful after, you know, half an hour. It came up with a middle location where it was. But I think in the most part this game fulfills exactly what it needs to do. It is a fun, you know, shooting experience. It is a bit like a cross between GTA and sort of that sort of Saints Row, and I think it does that brilliantly. I think it sort of takes over from where Saints Row 2 really left off with the whole comedy, stupidity, action sort of thing. It doesn't take itself seriously either, you know, the fact that
Hello there, citizens. The majestic spires of Vigilator Nord have been taken down, just so you know. Nothing to worry about. Thank goodness. Everything's so normal. all of you in Eastern. Viva Medici!
That wonderful comedy. I'm no expert on sort of like billboards, but I'm not sure that can fly. It's actually a building. There is actually supposed to be a building there. Okay. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this playthrough, or sort of my initial impressions of play of this. As I say, it's a fantastic game. You know, if you want to pick it up, it's really worth the 40 quid that they're currently charging for it. It's brilliant. So, thank you very much for watching, and goodbye.